Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a long time since I uploaded another episode of this piece of hair doing. Hold on. Yeah, since I uploaded another video. I know I posted my bullet journal update last month and I said I would start posting more regularly again, but then life got in the way as it always does. I've just been really busy still trying to figure out where everything goes and just settling down. It's been probably like 5 weeks now since we moved and we still haven't unpacked everything, still have stuff to buy, stuff to put away, sort through. It may look like this room is set up. This is, by the way, our second bedroom, guest room, which I'm also planning to use as a filming room. It may look like it's kind of done now, but anything that is below this is a mess. Literally, I've got clothes strewn all around. My makeup is a mess. Just things everywhere. The bed that's in this room, my old bed. We still don't even have the mattresses in them yet because they're still at my boyfriend's parents' house. So yeah, it's been a while since I've been on here. It's been a while since I had the time also to just sit down and chat, but let's get into the haul. So yeah, we literally left with like 3 big bags, but we also, my boyfriend, I bought a winter coat for my boyfriend as well as some big pillows. So yeah, I'm actually gonna start with my boyfriend's coat because I really like it and I kind of want to wear it myself. Zip it up. I'm actually looking for a coat for me. I mean, I have plenty of like winter coats, but I don't have a decent raincoat. So I have a job now. It's a part-time job as a cashier registered thing at a, it's not a supermarket, it's like a huge store for restaurant owners and bar owners and stuff, where you can take and go shop for their food and stuff. Anyway, but it's in the town next over, so I go by bike every day. Now, luckily, I haven't really had to go through rain with my bike, because I was lucky that if it rained, my mom or sister or boyfriend could drop me off. But I know sooner or later I'm going to drive my bike through rain, and I don't actually own a proper raincoat, so I was like, I'm gonna check out, see if they have any in Primark. They have a lot of like lovely like my camel coat, like that style of coat, and like a lot of parkas with like fur on them and stuff, which is like my boyfriend's, which is like all great and stuff. But if you have to drive through rain, if it gets rainy, that just gets wet and just is not nice. So yeah, we did pick up this coat for my boyfriend. It wasn't that expensive anyway, so. And this is what it looks like. It's just a huge, it's kind of like a bomber style, but a bit more of a longer bomber style. And then it has a fur hood, like fur around the hood. Just like this. And this was only 25 euros, so great bargain from Primark. And it actually feels really nice. Feels really warm, but I still feel like he needs a nice dress-up coat. This is more of an everyday coat. But like I said, the Primark we went to, the clothing wasn't that super great. They had some nice bits, but nothing really. I was like, yes, this is nice. I'm just gonna continue in the trend with what my boyfriend bought. He is one of those people. When I say people, I mean kids. He is 26, but I mean, sometimes you would think he's like 12. He bought this. I don't know how I can show this, but can you see? So yeah, that is a shark. A shark troll. He bought a flipping shark troll. He's like, I want this thing. So it's basically like a big ass fleecy throat which you step in, and then you have kind of like, it's like a shark that's eating you just to land on the sofa. One thing I will give Primark is that they do the best throws and like fleecy soft blankets, because this is really soft. And this was, I think, 14 euros. I think I have the tag here. Yeah, this was 14 euros. So it's called a shark trail. If your man is a kid like mine, then he will probably love something like this. So yeah, and then I also bought two pillows for the sofa downstairs. We still needed some big pillows. Like, we had some little pillows to go on it, but nothing really big. So I picked up these two from Primark. So I've got two of these pink ones. Grab the other one. Look like this. So I'm a little bit more by car. Of course, parked close because we put these away. We put these in the trunk straight away. But yeah, the two big pink pillows. My boyfriend was so kind enough that you can buy the pink pillows. You can buy everything in pink because I am like slowly decorating the house, and like a lot of the color team is like this pale pink. I mean, I try not to pick pink for every room because I know my boyfriend. I mean, he won't complain, but I know it's not probably his favorite thing to be living in a white and pink house. But I love it. But yeah, anyway, so these are super soft. They're kind of like a suede type of material. And so one side is just like plain pink, and then the other side you can see like the stitching in across, which I think looks kind of neat as well. So yeah, and these are pretty big, and I think they were 10. It was 10 euros for a pillow, I think. Not sure. Okay, so then on to the next bits from Primark. I picked up some slippers. I had some old slippers, but the entire like bottom sole had like just disappeared from walking on them. So I picked up some new ones from Primark, and these are just fuzzy, furry insides with this suede-y, purpley red type of outside, and they have memory foam, and they also feel so soft to walk in. And these were only 5 euros, so super cheap. But then I picked up a pajama set because, I mean, I technically don't really need any new pajamas, but I wanted some new pajamas, let's say like that. And Primark has the best pajamas. Where is the light going? Okay, I'm back in focus. So Primark has the best pajamas. And these were 13 euros, I think. Yeah, for a satin three-piece set. They also had this in like a pale pink with cream polka dots, which looked amazing, but they didn't have any left in my size. They only have really big sizes left, and it's just lounge pants. I'm like, fine, whatever, I'll get like two sizes up. If they're too big, they're too big. But for actual pajamas, I like to have, like, especially the top, not be too big. So this is just a really cute set. I mean, these things are, like, great for gifts as well. They're blue with white stars. And, oh, they have, like, little, the buttons are, like, little stars. I didn't even notice that. So it's, like, a set of pajamas. And then it also has a sleeping mask. Okay, next up are some pink shoes. There is a lot of pink in this haul. I just really like pink. So these are some pink suede loafers, and I love these. They are just so cute. There's not much more to say, but they're just amazing. I mean, I won't have that many opportunities to wear these because I just wear my old boots to work with this because I have to stand up for 5 hours, and not my pretty shoes, so I will wear these whenever I'm not working. This is what they look like, and they're so adorably cute, and they actually feel pretty sturdy to walk in. And these were 13 euros, and I'm in a 37, which is a nice shoe size, and they fit pretty decent. These, I love them. You will definitely see those on my blog on here and on my Instagram, which, by the way, I will leave links to everything, all my social media and my blog, down below for you guys to check it out. Okay, then this is again my boyfriend's, but I mean, I should have picked them up for myself as well, because I know I'm gonna be living in this as well. This is just a plain blue hoodie. Hood, drawstrings, pocket. We all know what a hoodie looks like. This was 10 euros. It had to be in a bunch of different colors. So if you're looking for some hoodies, Primark men's section. I don't know why I didn't pick as another one for myself, because I know I will be wearing this more than you will probably wear, but yeah, that's that. Then I have a pink throw. Like I said, I love Primark their throws. I mean, they are so soft and they are relatively, you know, I mean, they're cheap, okay? This was 5 euros for this fleecy throw, and it's just so soft. It's like literally Primark has the softest throws in the world. This is 125 centimeters on 150 centimeters, so they're not the biggest throws, but they're nice to snuggle up under on the sofa. So yeah, that's that. We're almost there with Primark. As you can tell, you haven't seen any clothes from me yet. That is because I didn't really find that much that I liked. Like I said, Primark's often hit or miss. I either will like half of the store or I won't like anything in the store at this time. Plus it was really busy because we were on Saturday, but it was the only day I had off from work. So, yep. But I did pick up one piece of clothing, and that is this black jumper, which I'm sure you can't even see. It's just a knitted black jumper. You're all just seeing a black. It just has like little cuff sleeves, a little cuff on the bottom as well, and then it has like this detail which has like the choker and then the V neck. It just looks really nice. I haven't tried it on yet, but I'm sure I will love it. And I got this in a size small, and this was 18 euros. And yeah, I can't wait to just put this on with some skinnies, some black skinnies and some black boots, and just be ready to go. It's literally the only clothing item I picked up in Primark. Then I've got three more little things. And then the final empty. First of all, I picked up some shoe protector spray, because I needed some. It's just, you know, you spray this over your shoes and they are like waterproof and stuff. Yeah, so you basically spray this on your shoes and then they're waterproof, so they won't get like wrecked in the rain and stuff when it's winter. So is that. Then we picked up a tiny little candle. Primark has really nice candles, for really cheap as well. This was 1.50 euro for like this. I mean, it's not a huge jar, but it's called Number 2 Jungle Harlequin. It says sweet jasmine blossom with delicate raspberry tones. Honestly, I kind of smell like not chestnuts, but like, well, like a nutty, like some nuts I smell like in there. Yeah, maybe some jasmine. I'm definitely not smelling any raspberries in this, but it smells really nice. And the jar itself is also quite cute. So, okay, apparently I've been blabbing for 20 minutes. My camera cut off. Now, we have the dog traveling around here, so I'm sorry if you can pick that up on the mic. Just the dog, we'll ignore that. Going off downstairs. So now I have a couple more items. First thing is from Kreipfeld, just a new tangle teaser brush. This is a rose gold one, and it has a handle, and I just love these things. Yeah, and then the next, first of all, picked up this jumper from H&M. It's just like, it's not cropped, but it's also not long, so it's like perfect length, and it just sleeves and this little high neck, which I am loving high neck for winter. It's just in this icy gray. It's not really, yeah, you can kind of tell the color on camera. It's just like, it's not a white, or it's like an icy type of gray. It's a really lovely jumper. It's quite warm, but not too warm, so you can still wear it when it's a little bit warmer outside. Really love that. And then these, I, excuse me for the state of these, I just picked these out of the laundry, just washed these, so they're still a little bit warm. But these are some pants. They are from Kiabi, which is, I think it's a French store. They sometimes have really cute things. I have a few items from there. Maybe they're just like some blush. Is it a blush color? Yeah, it's kind of like an old pink blush, and they're just like regular pants, which, like I said, I literally took these out of the laundry just now. They have pockets. Do they have pockets? Yeah, they do. They have front and back pockets, and they just like a waist and just plain simple pants. And that's basically everything we picked up. So this was my Primark haul. I hope you guys liked it. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you did, and subscribe and turn on notifications so that you won't miss my next video. Should be next week. Should sort of get back into the schedule. I'm not promising anything, but I do have like more of these, and I am getting settled, so hopefully it will get a little bit easier to actually produce new content. So like I said, like, subscribe, turn on the notification. You can also check out my Instagram and my blog and Twitter and all that. I will link everything down below. I'll see you guys next week.